Hey, welcome back. Today is probably going to be a pretty short one. As I had mentioned though, I wanted to give away the solid file for this intake, talk a little bit about it, and also going to give away the files needed to do up the baseplate. Now you probably can't 3D print the baseplate. This is just a prototype one that I made with my 3D printer to check fits and stuff. And I'll talk about some of the problems with this and whatnot as well. And I'm also going to give away the files for making the exhaust for the RS100. And I think that's all the interesting stuff I have. I have a few like little 3D printed filler panels for weird things, but I don't think you guys really care about that too much. I'll start off by saying all of these files are given out on an as-is basis. There may or may not be issues that may arise with using them. I have no control over that. You're on your own. They're, again, provided no warranty, as is, they're just there. If you wanna try messing with them, you can go ahead. So starting off with this guy, this is a Honda Dio intake manifold. This one is printed out of nylon. However, ABS is probably, I printed other intake manifolds out of ABS and they're okay. They hold up pretty good. The other thing that's sweet about ABS is you can vapor smooth it with acetone. So if it has like little voids and holes, you can actually weld those areas over with like an acetone and a little bit of ABS melted into it solution. And you can like actually smooth out lines and clear up the inside and whatnot. So I don't know how good of a printer you're doing it on. There are the holes that run down through here and the space in between here is very thin. So you may end up with some small holes. And you can actually use that acetone method to fill in holes, like pinholes, if there was leaks in between here and here. Or you could use a sealer on these two front bolts. These ones aren't as bad, but these ones are the width here and these are, they're very, very close, like a few contour widths worth of space in between them. So it holds a GasGas reed block, which is good for like a 250 or 350 two-stroke. It's a pretty big reed block. You can get carbon reeds for them and stuff. So this one is a Delorto one. So the spigot is a little smaller. They do actually make this reed block as well. There's a, for a Keihin carburetor, up to a 28 mil. So you can just simply get that other one. It's a two-piece design. This is a one-piece design one. This is just what I had here. I think I'm gonna run a 26 millimeter Delorto on this. So you can basically just get swap out the other one. I think they'll both fit in the same voids, basically. There's not really anything you have to do there. These holes are two size. So when you print it, they're probably gonna end up being too small. On the GasGas, I think it uses an M5 through hole, but it's really close to an M6 on these upper ones. So you can probably get away with that. And on here, there's little grooves. And I actually just take a nut and a soldering iron and put it in there and then heat up the nut and sink it in enough that it goes in. And that way it actually bites the nut and keeps it grabbing. So when you don't have to use a wrench on those, the nut will always kind of stay locked down. Unless you overdo it, then it'll spin. But that's just the method that I've been using for setting like the nuts in the backside to lock everything down. And you'll probably need to lap all the faces on a piece of sandpaper. And once you've done that again, I would check it for leaks. If you make it at ABS, I would vapor smooth the inside and the outside with acetone to seal in any holes, check it for leaks, like blowing it and stuff. It does shoot the carb straight out the side of the bike, which is a bit annoying, but it's a direct shot down. There's the opening here is about as wide as the leaf pedals are gonna open the whole way, so it cuts down on space inside the intake track, because these have such a long intake track compared to some. So you may need to drill and ream these holes. I used a reamer because they were basically size for size. I just ran a reamer down them and that cleared them up. But again, knowing that these two are very, very close to these inner walls, just be advised that you should be pretty careful. Otherwise you may end up breaking through and then you'll have to do a repair on the inside. Next up, we have the base plate for the Stage 6 setup. Now I'm providing the STL and the SolidWorks file. There is an STL for the intake that I used, which is different than the Honda Dio pattern. It uses a 3-bolt system and cinches down, and then there's a blind of 2 hidden bolts and then 2 original. The original bolts go in there, and then there's they're hidden underneath the intake as it goes onto it. There are issues with this. So I drew it out for the O-ring setup. However, the O-ring doesn't fit very well, so I kind of put that aside and just used base gaskets for now. Maybe if I make another one in the future, I'll revisit that and try and get this correct. Trying to remember what it was exactly. I think some of these curves here aren't in the right position, so when you lay the rubber gasket in, it's not sitting where you want it to. And I believe there was something here, maybe this line needed to be moved up a hair in this direction. Also, again, it just didn't really align properly. You can make it without that groove in there, and then just use a base gasket, and it works okay. Although that is nice that it has an O-ring, so you can take the cylinder off and on a whole bunch of times and not really have to worry about anything, or you're messing up your squish once you've set it with like a base gasket underneath this. Although I wouldn't use a base gasket under this unless you had one made specifically for this profile. But anyway, using this, you will have to cut your, well, you don't have to, but the old intake bridge, you cut that out, and then your intake opening is significantly larger. You're getting rid of a rather large restriction on the Honda motors. The intake as well is similar to this. It just bolts onto here, and then it uses a Melosi VL 16 14, can't recall. It's the same reed block that's on the RC1. And then the 360 degree boot, and you can swivel it however you want. Same deal. I would probably print the intake out of ABS. This I would make out of metal. I would not 3D print this, although it might work. If you wanted to try some experiments, you might be able to get it to work. Although these need to be tapped, and I don't know if after a while if the heat would blow the studs out of there or not. But it was discussed when I made this whether or not it would actually work 3D printed. I mean, it might work for a little while, but I don't think it would work for a long time. But the file's there. You can get the measurements, machine your own if you want to, make yourself a hybrid motor. The intake design is there, so you can make yourself an intake as well. We'll just go over and take a quick peek at it, and I can point out it out on the bike what I'm talking about. So this is the setup here. This is a reed valve and the intake boot off of an RC1. There is a setup you can get off of a Vespa. It's slightly bigger and allows you to run the even bigger carbs. Like this, I think the boot is 30 mil. No, sorry, it's 32 millimeter on the ID. Something like that. Anyway, so this is like pretty much the biggest carb I can get on there, which is the 30 mil. You can get one off of a Vespa, which allows you to get an even bigger boot, which allows you to run like up to like a 45 or a 48 mil carb if you're so inclined. This is the intake manifold that I 3D printed. It has nut inserts on the side here that are blind. You just heat them up and shove nuts in there. ABS. Vapor smoothed it, checked it for leaks and everything, and then the base plate, which is that plastic piece I showed you, and I have to run a small base gasket because I goofed up on the O-ring, but I was invested in this piece already, so I've just decided to run with it for now. And that's pretty much it. That again just allows you to run the Stage 6 RT cylinders, either the 70 or the 95cc flavor on this base. There is some stuff with the crank. You can make a crank that basically fits into here out of a 44 mil stroke crank. There's a two that I know of, which is the Tadia, and a CMR. The CMR requires machining out the pin from 16 millimeters to 18 millimeters. and then you can run a Pro-X rod to make the crank have enough travel for this cylinder kit. The other one, the Tata, already has an 18 millimeter pin, so you can basically just take it and make the crank that you want. I don't know of any other 44 mil stroke crank setups that easily fit. This has a Minarelli crank in it, yeah. So this one, I had to add a 2 millimeter spacer into the crankcase halves and machine back the webbing space a bunch, and then machine back the bearing pockets a millimeter on each side to get this one to fit. I could have used some thin set bearings and possibly gotten away with it. Went down from to like the 11 mil wide bearings that they use on some of those mini strokers, but I went the hard way and machined the cases so it's a permanent setup. And lastly is this, the RS100 pipe. It's tuned for a pretty high revving motor, so if you're planning on putting this on just a stock RS100, you're probably going to find it's not going to perform very well. But if you wanted to make an RS or a DT or an RT100 similar to the one that I made, this pipe might be a good fit for you. Again, I'm just going to give you all the DXFs needed to get the cones cut out or printed or however you want to do it. And that way you can just kind of decide on your own how you want to go about it. And there will be some fitting and finishing you're going to have to do. There's no orientation to all the cones, so I mean you're still going to have to like lay the thing out, tack it together, make sure it fits the way you want, then break it all apart, and then weld each piece individually. But it is what it is. It's free. So if you have something you wanted to play around with, you can do that as well. That pretty much covers all of this stuff. When you're getting into the SolidWorks files, if you're in there and wondering what the hell is this guy doing, why is he doing it this weird way, you're probably not wrong. I am an idiot. I've self-taught myself SolidWorks, so I might do stuff very backwards to the way that it's supposed to be done. So don't judge me on that. But all the dimensions you're gonna need are in there. I will say that the base plate may change the height according like to what you need may change. So I would err on the side of making the base plate thicker than you need it to be, and then machining it down to get the squish where you want it to be. But I think that's all my freebie stuff for the day. If I think of anything else, I will throw it down in the description as well. These are all provided for personal use, unless you're Stage6 and you want the files for this, because you want to make these for the Honda community, in which case, that we can talk. But I think that's it for me. Until next time, take care.